afternoon.
It's all on.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, graduates and guests. Wonderful to see you here at Newcastle University today. Really thrilled to be performing a graduation ceremony for you all. Sorry about the weather, but we'll try and make the atmosphere in here as warm and welcoming as we can. The first thing that's going to happen is that I will be asking you all to stand, and then the academic procession will come in through the rear door and they'll process up the centre aisle and take their seats here in front of us. They'll be following the Northumbrian piper, who'll pipe them forward, after which the presiding officer, who is Professor Harkness today, will formally open the ceremony. When he sits down, you can all sit down at that point. And then we turn to our graduates. Congratulations to our graduates. Well done on your achievement of getting your degree awards. You've all been given a seat with a number on, and you should be sitting in that seat to get the right name called out as you go across the stage. You should have your hood on your right arm. The marshals will ask you to stand a row at a time, and you'll walk forward nice and slowly, no rush, and come right up onto the stage on an individual basis, one at a time. There's an X marks the spot. Come right up onto the stage, because the hooding marshal will take your hood and will hood you on stage. They don't need any help with this. They can do this for you. So you stand and look at the audience, and the hooding marshal will put the hood on for you. The different coloured hoods that we have today signify the different degrees, the different awards that have been achieved. Once your hood's on, your name will be called out, and you walk across the stage to shake hands with the presiding officer, Professor Harkness. Anyone for cultural or health reasons not want to shake hands, if you hold a brochure, we know that you still acknowledge and smile and say hello, but that you don't want to shake hands. After which, you go down the centre aisle and file back into the seat that you vacated a short time before. Because you're going back to the same seat, you don't need to bring any bags or coats or mobile phones or anything like that. Leave them all on your seat and get you back with them after you've been presented across the stage. We applaud each and every graduate. Not everybody has friends and family here. However, pace yourselves. We have about 100 to applaud, and we do like the last ones to receive the same applause as the first ones. Apart from applause, we like the ceremony to be quiet and ceremonial. So if you could turn your cameras and phones and that to silent, that would be appreciated. We don't want them going off in the middle. Please take photographs. Just I ask you not to stand up in front of the people sitting behind you. The next graduate across the stage might belong to the friend or family of the people sitting behind you. So please, just a bit of consideration, but yes, take photographs if you want for your memories of today. After all of the graduates have passed the stage, we're delighted that we have a student orator who's going to make a speech on behalf of all of the students here today. After which, you'll be asked to stand, the ceremony will be formally closed, and the academic procession will go back out down the centre aisle and out through the south door. A little annoyingly, I will ask you all to sit again. And then we allow our graduates to file out of the north door, where we can give them a collective round of applause as they're filing out of the hall. We ask the graduates, even though it's raining, to move out, go through the quadrangle and into the student forum, where they can meet with you, because you can follow the graduates out of the hall once they've all left. We have a light refreshment for you indoors, you'll be pleased to know, in the Hadrian Building upstairs in the Lindisfarne Room. So please make your way collectively, all of you, over to the Lindisfarne Room once you've met up with each other again in the student forum. I hope you have a wonderful time here at Newcastle. Enjoy the ceremony, which will hopefully be starting in a few moments' time. Thank you very much. Thank you.
I hereby declare open this congregation, which is held for the conferment of university awards. Good evening, everyone. My name is Nigel Harkness, and I'm Pro Vice Chancellor for the Faculty of Humanities and Social Sciences, which is where our School of Geography, Politics, and Sociology is located. And it's my great privilege and pleasure to welcome you to this graduation ceremony in the wonderful surroundings of King's Hall. I'd also like to welcome the graduands, their family, and friends who were unable to attend today, but who will be watching the ceremony as it's streamed online around the world. So for us at Newcastle University, graduation ceremonies are one of the highlights of the university year. They are joyous, and as you can see from what we're wearing on the stage, very colorful occasions when you, as graduates of the university, earn the right to wear with pride the robes that symbolize the award of your academic qualifications. There are also occasions when graduands, you join your families, your friends, your tutors, and your fellow students to celebrate the successes you've worked so hard to achieve. And I hope this is also a moment for you to pause and reflect, just to think about how far you've come, to reflect on your achievements, and possibly also to look forward to all that the future holds in store for you after this ceremony, after you've completed your degree. You're here today because of your hard work, your dedication, your perseverance, your ability to rise to and successfully meet the challenges of your courses, and courses which in some cases have taken place, of course, against the backdrop of the disruption of the global pandemic. Today is then a special opportunity for you to share those achievements with families and friends and loved ones, and I hope you'll enjoy every minute of today, the ceremony itself, the reception afterwards, and whatever you've got planned after the reception. But you couldn't have achieved what you have done without many of the people in the hall today or who are watching online. First of all, your friends and family who've been there alongside you all through your degree, offering advice, encouragement, and support, moral, certainly, possibly also financial. And secondly, as a graduating class, you wouldn't be here today without the academic and administrative teams in GPS who've been there with you throughout your degree, some of whom are seated on the stage behind me. Their exceptional academic talent, their inspirational teaching, and their dedicated mentoring and support have enabled you as a graduating class to fulfill your full potential. So both these groups of people, your tutors, your friends and families, have been there when you've needed them and have contributed to your success. So can I ask you all just to join me in thanking them with a big round of applause. And to our graduating class, don't worry, the rest of the applause is for you. So today we're conferring a range of undergraduate and postgraduate degrees from our School of Geography, Politics and Sociology. So geography, politics and sociology are disciplines embedded in the world. The Russian invasion of Ukraine, the ongoing tragedies of Israel, Palestine, gender inequality, climate change, global pandemics, racism, migration, the effects of the Anthropocene, the continuing legacies of colonialism, poverty, violence, capitalism, and revolution. All are linked to geographical, political, and social relations. Who we believe ourselves to be, and the ways in which we connect with and separate ourselves from others by where we live and how we live. And with all of these topics, things aren't getting any easier. Climate change is accelerating, bringing with it challenges of migration, famine, violence, poverty, and war. While the specters of racism, nationalism, and xenophobia attempt to persuade societies that others deserve to suffer. And we have new challenges, like the role of artificial intelligence, rising inequality, visceral identity politics, and societies sometimes feeling as if they're bereft of hope. But hope is what today's graduates can bring us. Their skills, their knowledge can build up hope so that we can address these enormous global challenges in ways that are effective, fair, inclusive, and equitable. If I just turn briefly and turn to each of the three broad disciplinary areas represented today. Human geography is interested in how spaces and places mediate relations of power and or reflect long-standing environmental processes. And physical geography studies processes that shape the Earth's surface, the animals and plants that inhabit it, and the spatial patterns they exhibit. So if you want to know about how where you live affects your life chances, or if you're concerned about the potential impacts of global warming on delta regions, the possibilities of landslides, or changes to ecosystems, our geography graduates are the people to go to find out those answers. Politics and international relations are the study of local, national, and global relations of power, how we shape these relations of power, and how we are shaped by them. Politics and international politics give us insights into how our beliefs, fears, thoughts, and political affiliations are connected to institutions, legal regimes, economic relationships, and cultures. And they give us insights into what causes the perpetuation of inequalities, and even more importantly, they give us insights into the possibilities for progress. Finally, sociology draws our attention to how we are embedded into relationships, with others that shape us and make the worlds around us meaningful in particular ways. So our sociology graduates have gained insights into how our understandings of gender, race, religion, or class have changed and why they may have changed. And studying sociology has helped them understand the diversity of perspectives on issues from global warming to migration within particular groups in society. So these degrees that we are going to award today have provided graduates in the room with critical thinking skills, the knowledge that everything is contingent, historically situated, and relational. They embrace the complexity of the world and grapple with it. Most of all, graduates from these programs avoid reverting to single cause explanations for complex challenges. And in the careers that our graduating class will go on to, we know from previous graduates and our alumni that graduates from the programs that we're awarding degrees in today use the knowledge, skills, and confidence developed over the course of their degree programs to try to make a positive difference in the world. So that was just a few words about the disciplines that we are graduating today. I just want to say a few things to our graduating class of 2023. So as a graduating class, you entered this hall today as graduands, not graduates, graduands. That is to say, someone who has completed the requirements for your degree, but whose degree has not yet been awarded. When you cross the hall today, when you undergo the hooding ceremony, when your hood is placed over your head and you process across the stage, that's when your degree is awarded. That's when you have full rights to wear, I hope with pride, those academic robes. When you cross the stage today in that transition from a graduand to a graduate, I hope you'll step down from the stage and leave the hall today as proud graduates of Newcastle University. And as you look forward to embarking on the next chapter of your lives and to putting the skills and knowledge you've acquired through your degree to use in what I know will be rewarding careers, I want you to remember that you've got a vital part to play as ambassadors for this university in bringing to life our vision of Newcastle as a world-leading university, advancing knowledge, providing creative solutions, and solving global problems. As Newcastle graduates, I hope you'll share our aspiration as a university to harness our academic excellence, creativity, and innovation for the benefit of society. But simply, I hope you will share our aspiration to make people's lives better. And as a Newcastle University graduate, you are joining a constantly growing global community of over 250,000 fellow alumni. And that alumni network is there to support and inspire you professionally and socially wherever your career, your life may take you right around the world. So please be active in that network. It will help you discover the opportunities and benefits that are available to you. And most of all, when you leave today, I hope you will stay in touch, not just with each other, but also with us, with colleagues in the school, with colleagues in the wider university. And we very much look forward to welcoming you back as alumni to share your stories and to enable future generations of students to benefit from your experience, expertise, and to learn from your successes. So today's graduation is not an end. It's a beginning. Whether you're about to embark on your career, go on to even more study after a bachelor's or a master's degree, or to travel the world, I want you to know how proud we are of all that you have achieved and of all that you will go on to achieve in the future. So, graduating class of 2023, on behalf of everyone at Newcastle University, congratulations and well done to you all. We wish you success, happiness, and fulfillment in all that you go on to do. Go well, class of 2023. Thank you.
Professor Harkness, I certify that the candidates to be presented at this congregation have satisfied all the requirements of the university. Professor Harkness, the head of School of Geography, Politics and Sociology, prays leave to present candidates who are qualified to proceed to awards in the School of Geography, Politics and Sociology.
Professor Grayson.
Professor Harkness, I present to you candidates to be admitted to the awards in the School of Geography, Politics, and Sociology.
By the authority of the university, I admit these candidates to the awards for which they are now qualified.
The following graduate is presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Politics, Huda Hunino. The following graduate is presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Politics and Sociology, Daisy Taylor. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with honors in Geography, James Richard Belfield. Amelia Grace Davies. Madeline Matthews. Willa McFrederick. Harry Morris. George Warrior. Jemima Grace Webb. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with honors in International Relations. Amber Amelia Carr. Woo! Jack Talbot. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with honors in politics. Oscar Miles Huntley Bainbridge. Sophie Lauren Fletcher. Henry Charles Ludlam. Marcus John Schofield Bezer. The following graduate is presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with honors in Politics and International Relations, James Harry Marshall. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with honors in Politics and Sociology, Thomas Patrick Sewell Johnston. Kate Elizabeth Long. Polly Alice Walton. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with honors in Sociology, Katie Eldred. Rebecca Amy Marie Hutchinson. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Bachelor of Science with honors in Geography. Melanie Kate Bettles. Emily Maureen Harvey. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Human Geography Research. Abigail Rose Hardcastle. Charlie John Harper. Katie Rebecca James. Veronica Kaczmierska. Owen Lowery Pearson. Ichimati Musamputri. Isabel Catherine Pierce. Prairana Saki Mukapogu. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in International Political Economy. Ebrahim Albraidi. Noor Alain Khalid. George Waterhouse. Mm-hmm. Moni Zhu. The following graduate is presented for the degree of Master of Arts in International Politics, Critical Geopolitics. Martha Elizabeth Airy. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in International Politics, Global Justice and Ethics. Emily Laura Gray. Amy Hamilton. Phoebe Wells. Katie White. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in International Politics, Globalization, Poverty, and Development. Alistair Peter Duffield. Faye Izzard. Amelia Noak. Sri Jaswi Traka. Hitomi Walshaw. The following graduates are presented for a degree of Master of Arts in International Relations. Luke Balatoni. Annabelle Barker Moore. Kiran Bishnoi. Ryan Alexander Jason Carter. Huria Suda Jashun. Edward Folds. Nikita Girish. Isabel Alice Greenwood. Oliver Hartman. Rajvant Kaur. Krishnani Kunwar. Gregor Gordon Murray. Carol Dory Nader. Kieran James Sadler. Zhuzheng Shuai. Yuan Kai Tai. Grace Wahoo. Megan Leanne Walsh Udale. Austin Wang. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Politics Research. Daniel Mark Greenhuff. Terry Hankinson. Henry Johnston. Henry John Ryby. Kim Tate. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Sociology. Sutan Gao. Nia Langford. Young Yi Peng. Molly Preston. Megan Rose Rimmer. Megan Abigail Swanson. Xingyi Zhai. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Sociology and Social Research. Maryam Shaiz Alanadzi. Mohammed Amr Ali. Catherine Busby. Owen William Creeley. Eleanor Kate Howley. Linda Lau Renchani. Amelia Claire Rudforth. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in World Politics and Popular Culture. Zhao Wen Thomas Choi. Eleanor Crook. Benjamin Hayward. William Alexander Hemme. Lewis William Scott. Asha Thompson. Sophie Thompson. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Research in Environmental Geoscience. Isabella Clark. Catherine Grace Vallely. Jovan Lee Josh Vincent. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. For research exploring young people's experiences of art projects, Florence Agnes Darling. For research in large-scale sediment architecture of Skeiðarársandoyrá, Southeast Iceland, Devin Harrison. For research in exploring millennial loneliness in County Durham, Jesse Rachel Kelly Baxter. For research in an exploration of women's lived experiences of period poverty and menstrual injustice, Lottie Victoria Rhodes. For research in gender, heterosexuality, intimacy, and technology, Melissa K. Rose Whitaker. At this point in the ceremony, we would like to draw your attention to the list of graduates who have been awarded academic prizes. The list can be found at the center of the congregation brochure. Please join me in giving these graduates a warm round of applause. Before the proceedings are brought to a close, I'm delighted to introduce our student orator, Annabelle Barker Moore, who graduated with the degree of Master of Arts in International Relations. Annabelle will address the congregation on behalf of the students we are celebrating here today.
Graduates, guests, and esteemed scholars of Newcastle University, I am deeply honoured and humbled to stand here today. Congratulations, graduates. Today is a day of great significance as we gather here to celebrate the culmination of our academic journey, a moment filled with pride, accomplishment and a touch of nostalgia. Today marks the beginning of a new chapter in our lives, a chapter filled with endless possibilities and boundless potential. It is a day to celebrate with our family and friends as we reflect on the transformative journey we've taken during our time at Newcastle University. Over the past year, I don't think I'm alone in saying that perhaps there were times in which I was unsure if I would be walking across this stage today. And in those times, I relied on others who are in this room for guidance and support. Fellow graduates, I'm sure if you look around right now, you could acknowledge those who showed up for you when you needed it the most. Whether it was a member of staff who offered valuable advice, a guardian who believed in your potential, or a friend who provided unwavering encouragement, they played an indispensable role in your journey. On behalf of all graduates today, I would like to thank each and every member of staff and family and friends who travelled to be here. Your unbelievable love and support is a huge token of confidence, and we are truly thankful for it. I thank each and every member of staff for nurturing our curiosity, to the faculty for their unwavering dedication, to our families and loved ones for their unyielding support, and to my fellow graduates for making this journey unforgettable. Alongside academic achievements, we have forged friendships that will last a lifetime and crafted cherished memories that will forever define this chapter in our lives. Remember the late night study sessions and the endless cups of coffee? Those were the moments that not only fueled our caffeine addictions, but also cemented the friendships that will last beyond today. I feel incredibly lucky to have been surrounded by such a supportive and intelligent cohort. These treasures are just as valuable. They have shaped our characters, imparted valuable life lessons, and enriched our lives. Our university experience has been a crucible of personal growth, challenging us to embrace the obstacles that cross our paths and acquired knowledge that will serve as our compass in the uncharted territory of the future. It has been a journey of self-discovery, one where we have honed our skills and acquired knowledge to serve as our compass in the uncharted territory of the future. Our education equips us to tackle global concerns, to innovate, and to create positive change. The world awaits the contributions of this extraordinary cohort. As we leave this ceremony today, let us carry with us the memories that we have created, the friendships we have forged, and the knowledge that we have developed as we step into the world with enthusiasm, curiosity, and unwavering determination. Let us remember that we are not just gaining a degree, but we are becoming a part of an incredible alumni who have achieved remarkable things. Today marks not just the end of a chapter, but the beginning of a new and exciting journey. The opportunities that await us are vast, and I have no doubt that we will seize them with open arms. May we navigate the challenges that are ahead with grace and perseverance, knowing that we will always have the support and camaraderie of our fellow graduates. Class of 2023, we made it. I wish you all from the bottom of my heart a sincere congratulations and good luck.
Please now stand.
So with those words, those inspirational words from Annabel, that brings the formal part of today's proceedings to a close. I am just going to plagiarize Annabel, if I may, and reiterate one thing she said, which I think is a fitting conclusion before I dissolve this ceremony. The world awaits the contributions of this exceptional cohort of students. I think that's a very positive message to end on today. So with that, graduates, enjoy the rest of the day, enjoy the rest of the evening. and I hope you have a wonderful time with friends and family. This congregation is now dissolved.
I'm shortly going to invite the graduates to leave the hall. I would just like to remind everyone that we're making our way through the quadrangle into the student forum and then across the student forum to the Lindisfarne Hall, which is in the Hadrian Building. I hope you have a wonderful day here at Newcastle University. Thank you.